Hello, so now we are going to start with a new set of shortcuts, which is control plus all of these buttons. Now the numbers which you see over here, 1 to 0, these are all the numbers which are there on the top of your keyboard. These are not the numbers which is there in your number pad or the number keypad on the right. There is a difference between the numbers on the top of your keyboard and between the numbers that is there on your keypad. So I'm just referring over here to the numbers which is there on the top of your keyboard, right? Now the first is control plus this tilt sign which you see, this sign which you see in within the brackets. Now this is known as the tilt sign. This is generally there below the escape button or above the tab button. This is used to show or hide the formulas. Now suppose I have done a small calculation. I've written 7, 8 and I've done a E70 plus E79 over here, and here I've done another calculation. I've took this cell and multiplied this with 2. Now let us just click on control tilt, and we see that, just ignore this expansion for a moment, and we can see that we have the both the formulas over here which is being shown now. So all the formulas in your worksheet will become visible once you click on control tilt, right? And again when you click on control tilt, it's back to normal, it hides the formulas again. So this is how it works basically. You can show the sign using the, you can show all the formulas using control tilt. All the formulas which is there in your worksheet will be visible, and again when you click on control tilt, it again hides all the formulas. Then we have control 1 which is used to format the cell. So let us just click on this control 1, and you have this format cell dialog box over here. So you can just simply change the alignment, font, you can add borders, you can change the color, fill color of the cell, and all these sort of things which you can do using the, either you do the using the home tab, or you can do this either by clicking on right clicking and using format cells. So these are the two ways. So this is the shortcut control 1, which is used to format the cell. The next we have control 2, which is bold. So I'll click on control 2 and it changes my cell to bold. Again I'll click on control 2 and it removes the bold. Control 3 is for italics, so I'll just click on control 2 and see, changed my cell to italics. Again I'll click on control 2 and it control 3 and it again changes it back. So again control 3, it changes it to italic. Control 3, back to normal. Underline is control 4. So control 4, see, it underlines my word. And then again you can click on control 4. If you all remember, we have one more shortcut as control U, which is for underline. So this is underline control 4. Then strike through, if you all remember, control 5, it is control S as well. It's control 5 only. So we click on the control 5 and it simply strikes through the word. Control 5, again back to normal. We don't have any shortcut keys for control 6 and control 7. Then we have the control 8, which is the outline. So basically what do I mean by outline? Cannot show outline symbols because no outline exists in the current worksheet. Generally this is there. See, can you just see this thing expanded over here? This is nothing but the outline. So basically we add outlines to the columns. It's general expansion. The column opens up basically. And so as you can see, it column opens up over here. As you can see, it hid my columns. So these are the columns in which my your outline exists. Can you see 77 to 80? So again, I'll just click on control 8. This is how you make the use of outline. I'll show you all in my next video as well how to use outline. I'll show you all how to add outlines to your columns as well. Moving on to the next, we have, so we create outline by simply just selecting the rows. Suppose I want to create an outline over here. What do I mean by outline is that I do not want maybe these rows to be seen. So what do? I just select all these rows together. I go to the group in the data tab. in the outline section you have this group, and you click on the group, and you can see there is one minus sign over here. Once you click on this minus sign, your all the rows are hidden now. So this is how you create a outline. You can do the same for the columns as well. See, your columns are now hidden. So now basically why do we use Control D is to hide this and this outlines over here, to hide or show these lines. So I'll just click on Control 8 and see both the outlines are hidden. Again, when I click on Control D 8, both the outlines are now shown. So this is how you create an outline and use Control 8 to show and hide the outlines. You can again remove all the outlines if you want to, just by clicking in the ungroup section in this clear outline heading. The next we have the control line, which is used to hide the rows. So if I'm on this row, if I'm on this cell and I click on control line, then see it simply hit that particular row, 82 and 84. So 83 row is hidden. So again I click on control 9. So okay, I'll just have to take this cursor to this particular point and you can just, to unhide it, you can obviously right click over here and click on unhide. So this is how you unhide your rows. So that was control 9. Then control 0 is to hide the column. So I'll just click on control 0 and it hit my column. Again, to get it back, you just have to right click and unhide it. The next we have control minus. So this minus is to delete the selection. Suppose you have selected a group of cells and you then click on control minus. It basically says that what do you want to do with these selected range, cell range. Do you want to shift it up left? That means both the all these cells will be removed and it will shift to the left. Or do you want to shift it to the right or down? So I don't want to, I'll just select one particular cell. So let us just write something over here and let us just try to delete this particular exact selection. So I'll just click on control minus and it will take my cell up. So as you can see, it just simply took it up and it deleted. So I'll just give one more example. So if I want to delete this, basically nothing will happen. This will be removed. This entire column will shift one cells up. So you can see if you have anything above it or as well, it will shift one column, one row up. So I'll write one more number and you can see 77 is in column number row number 83, 99 is in row number 85. So when I delete this particular cell over here, control minus, and I want to shift it up, okay. So what happened, this remained the same in the call in the row number 83. This moved up in the row number 84, which was earlier in row number 85. So this is how you delete the current selection. Then you have, okay, so how do you write a minus sign? If you simply click on minus over here and just click on enter, then it might not take the value as minus. Now why is this so? Because we use in Excel, we use minus, plus and equal to. All these are given, all these tell Excel that you are going to write or you are going to input certain formulas. If you just click on equal to and just as you can see, I have used a single quotation over here. Now why I have used a single quotation and then I have used a minus sign? Because by simply writing a plus sign and clicking on enter, or maybe clicking on any other cell, this tells Excel that you are going to input certain formula. But I am not going to write any formula. I just want a plus sign over here. Or maybe if you want equal to and then a plus sign. So then it gives you an error, because you will not able to get a equal to and minus sign together, because then it says that okay, you are going to input certain formula which is incomplete. Now what after plus? So then, if you all remember, we have done this when we were doing the various methods of writing a comment. We just give a single quote over here. This single quote signifies that you are, whatever you write after this quote is a comment for the Excel, and it is not to be taken as a formula. It is simply a comment or simply any text which you are writing. This is not to be executed or considered as a formula. So as you can see, now you can easily write equal to and a plus sign together, which is otherwise very difficult because it is being taken as a formula, so it will give you an error. So that was the one thing. And then we have the next as equal to. There is nothing, no shortcut for control equal to. Then we have control and the open bracket. So this is the third bracket or the square bracket, square open bracket, which is for direct dependence. Now what is direct dependence? Basically, suppose I take this cell, this is directly dependent on 7 and 8 over here, which is E78 and E79. So when I am on this particular cell and I click on control open bracket, it directly takes me to the direct dependence which I have. So this was E78 and E79. This was a direct dependent for this particular cell. So similarly, I am on this cell and I calculated 30 as 15 into 2, which is E80 into 2. Now when I am on this particular cell and I click on control open bracket, see, it took me straight away to this particular cell. It takes you to the direct dependence. And even if you have any inputs from any other sheet, it will take you there. Suppose if I have any of my input over here and I click on control open bracket over here, it will straight away take me. So you need to take your cursor to the cell, to the output cell, and then you have to click control open bracket, and the moment you click on control open bracket, it takes you to the input cells, all the input cells. The next we have control open close bracket, close square bracket, which is all dependents. So basically it will take you to all the previous dependents. So here, as you can see, I have selected these two cells, I have added these two cells, and in here I have multiplied this cell. So now if I click on, if I am on this particular cell 30 and I click on control open bracket, control close bracket, sorry. As you can see, it takes you to the whenever you are on any input, it takes you to the output. So if I am in this cell 7 and I click on control open bracket, it took me to 15. Again, when I click on control open bracket, it took me to 30. And if you've used this 30 anywhere else, it takes you to that particular cell. So this is the opposite of control open bracket. In the control open bracket, basically you get all the input cells which you have used for a particular output, and control closing brackets gives you all the dependents, basically all the outputs in which this particular cell is used. So again, control closing bracket, it took me to 15. Again, closing bracket, it took me to 30, because in 30 I have used this particular cell. Again, if I am on 30 and I click on control, sorry, when I am on 7 and I click on control closing bracket, it took me to 15. Control closing bracket, it takes me to the this particular cell, which is 30, which is the output where I have used this particular input. Now when again I am on 30, I click on control open bracket, it takes me to 15. Control open bracket, and all these are selected as the input cells. So it is exact opposite. One gives you the all the inputs. So this gives you all the inputs which you have used, and this give you the outputs in which you have used that particular cell. The next we have to insert a particular date, which is control semicolon. So I'll just click on control semicolon over here, and it gives me the today's date. Now this today's date is not going to update when you open this tomorrow. It will still remain 29th May 2020, because this is not the date function or the current date function which you use in Excel. So we have used the date function when we were doing date and time, That gives you current date, and whenever you reopen your workbook any day later, it gives you the current date. But this gives you only today's date, which is 29th May 2020. Even if you open it tomorrow, you'll get the same date. Then we have the control apostrophe, which is to insert upper cell value. Now, what is upper cell value? I'll just give you an example over here. Let us suppose I write a value, say, maybe any value. Yes, suppose I write a yes over here, and I want the same value over here, which is there, to be pasted in this particular cell. So what do I do? Control apostrophe, and see, it just pastes the upper cell value. Control apostrophe. And if you have something else, suppose if I have written over here yes and hello, so basically if I'm in this cell and I click on control apostrophe, it simply pastes the exact value which is there in the exact upper cell. It will not consider the values which is there in the above cells as well, so it won't take those values. It just takes the value which is there in the exact above cell. So that was control apostrophe. This button is there beside the enter key, on the left of the enter key. Then we have the colon. So enter plus colon gives us, it inserts the time basically. So I'll click on control colon, and it gives you okay, so this is not for the insert time. This is same as the date which you have over here. So I'll just remove this, because this is same as the semicolon which we used above. So these were the shortcut keys which you have seen using the control key. You may write it all down, and these can be used. These are very generally used very widely. Why? Because you have all these very nice formatting options. Then you have something related to the cells and the columns. Then you have related to the formulas. And then you have the date and the insert upper value, basically copy pasting your values which is there in the exact above cell. So this is how you use the control plus all of these shortcuts. In our next class, we are going to learn some new shortcuts.